Welcome students. Now in this video we are going to talk about this peritectic transformation, or little bit in details about this peritectic reaction, dear students. So what is this peritectic reaction or this transformation? Here this liquid react with one solid. See, here liquid is going to react with the solid A, and it will form the another solid, that is the solid B, isn't it? So what is mean by actually peritectic reaction? So dear students, peri is it's a Greek word, that is means around. Peri means around. Okay, that is the meaning. Actually, just keep it in mind. We will come to know why it is called it as peritectic. Okay, so what are the very famous examples for this reaction, dear students? We are having iron carbon, copper zinc, aluminium titanium, and this niobium iron and this boron. Okay, so this is the strong magnet. Actually, this is also having this peritectic transformation or peritectic reaction. So dear students, this copper and zinc, that is nothing but the classical brass. This is the classical brass, is the peritectic alloy, is the peritectic alloy system. That is, it is having more than five peritectic reactions. Okay, and dear students, the very famous reaction in this iron carbon equilibrium diagram, that is the reaction at the higher temperatures, and the carbon percentage around 0.13%. See, at this extreme left, you will be having this reaction, dear students. Okay, so this is delta, this is delta plus gamma, this is liquid plus delta. Okay, and it will use you this gamma austenite. Okay, and of course here is the liquid. So this is what delta plus liquid is going to form, that is delta iron plus liquid, when cooled it will going to form this gamma austenite, this gamma austenite. So this is the peritectic reaction at, dear students, 0.13% carbon, very very low percentage of carbon, dear students. Okay, generally we can see these reactions in the stainless steels. Okay, so dear students, this is about the peritectic transformation. Now when I say the peritectic transformation, so if you look at the phase diagram, how you can able to understand whether it is a peritectic or eutectic? So definitely, dear students, when we see the diagram like this, definitely like this, here we are having some detailed explanation about this peritectic transformation, dear students. So you can see here, dear students, this component A and this B, it's of course binary alloy system. The temperature, melting point temperature of A, this is TA, and you can see here this melting point temperature of this B, you can see. So whenever in the phase diagram, there will be the huge difference in the temperatures of the given elements or given components, definitely you can say that there will be this peritectic reaction. So when you can say that, so when there is large temperature difference, there will be the which phase diagram? Peritectic phase diagram. Large temperature difference between these two components or elements, it will show you the peritectic phase diagram. Please, dear students. Okay, so dear students, Now in this phase diagram, see, this, of course, this liquid plus alpha, that is one liquid react with one solid, and it is going to give us what? This another solid. So here liquid react with this alpha, during cooling it will form this beta, isn't it? So this is the peritactic reaction we are having. So dear students, if we see here, so how many two phase fields are here? So this is two phase field, this is two phase field, and this is two phase field. So here we are having three two phase fields. How many single phase fields? How many single phase fields? One, the liquid alpha and beta, that is the three phase fields, single phase fields. Okay, and when you come to this peritactic point where the peritactic reaction is going to happen at temperature, say I am saying that this temperature where the peritactic reaction is happening, that is temperature TP. Okay, so dear students, here the peritactic reaction happening at what? This temperature TP, where this liquid plus alpha is trying to form the solid beta. At peritactic point P, this is the peritactic point P. Okay, so at the peritactic point, dear students, if you are going to apply the phase rule or the Gibbs phase rule, so what we can write here, dear students, so how many number of phases we are going to apply the phase rule at this point? So if I apply here, so number of phases are how many? Number of phases, of course, 1, 2 and 3, number of phases 3. How many components, dear students? Of course, this is binary system, so components are 2. So apply these Gibbs phase rule, that is P plus F is equal to C plus 1. We are applying the condensed phase rule. So phases 3 plus degree of freedom we are going to calculate, components 2 plus 1. So 3 get cancelled, so degree of freedom will be, dear students, 0. So once again you can say that, dear students, this point, okay, the point P is what? That is the invariant point. We cannot move from that point, because as soon as you move up or down or at the sides, definitely you will be thrown out of the composition, isn't it? So that is the reason why, dear students, this point P is the invariant point. Okay, so point P is invariant point where the degree of freedom is equal to 0, isn't it? Now dear students, say let us discuss the reaction. Let us discuss the reaction here, dear students. So say as this liquid starts cooling on the liquidus, so once again I will draw this, just I am drawing the diagram for understanding. So this is liquid, this is alpha, this is alpha plus beta, this is beta, alpha plus liquid, liquid plus beta, okay, and this is say A, B, percentage of X in B, this is dA, this is TB. Okay, so dear students, so what is going to happen here? Of course, this is our peritactic point, and this line, horizontal line, will give us the reaction, that is liquid plus alpha undergoing cooling forms beta. Okay, this is a peritactic reaction. So now dear students, as liquid start cooling, as see this liquid start cooling on this liquidus line, on this liquidus line, of course I am taking this, I am the taking say this point for the understanding, P point, P that is peritactic point, and the composition at that is X in P. Okay, and here temperature will be. So dear students, when I start cooling this liquid below this this liquidus line, below this liquidus line, and the temperature will be what here? say temperature will be say TL on the liquidus line. So below which the liquid start converting into what? So below this, definitely this alpha rich region, isn't it? So A rich region, definitely the alpha is the interstitial solid solution. So as soon as you just come down below this liquidus line, so there will be the formation of what? The alpha. And say this alpha is going to start to form in which manner? From say TL, from this TL to TP, so just below this liquidus line, alpha start forming, and after nucleation or after this alpha get formed, it will try to grow, isn't it? From where to where? From TL to TP, isn't it? So dear students, so if I draw here, and very very popularly or very basic we have understand that, so very easy phase or very easy structure to get nucleate, that is the dendritic fashion, isn't it? So see here, I am saying that says by somehow this alpha is getting formed and it get grown like a dendrite. Okay, so alpha grow like dendrite. Dendritic structure. Now dear students, the temperature just go below this TP, what will happen? So now from here, just below liquidus, alpha start forming in the term of say very common structure, the dendritic fashion, and from TL to TP it start getting growing, and it is grown in between the temperature TL to TP. Now dear students, now you just cool again below the TP line, below this TP, what will going to happen? So definitely the beta is formed between the liquid and this alpha. So dear students, alpha is here, isn't it? And say here is a liquid, so here is a liquid, it is surrounded with the liquid. Now just below TP, what is going to form? So definitely, so beta is going to form, dear students. So I will show it with this blue color. So because of liquid, see, because of this liquid plus alpha, this liquid plus alpha just below TP, we are saying, dear students, now on this alpha the beta starts forming. Okay, the beta starts forming. Okay, so dear students, beta will going to form the layer because of the reaction between this alpha and liquid, beta is formed. Now dear students, as soon as this beta layer is formed, this reaction is going to stop. This reaction is going to stop because the layer of beta is formed on this alpha dendrite. So definitely when the reaction is going to stop, so there will not be any further increase of this beta. So this blue color, dear students, is the layer of beta. So of course this liquid and alpha is now, they are not directly in contact with each other, definitely in between them beta has come. So definitely reaction gets stopped, so no more beta is going to form, dear students. But dear students, of course still this reaction is continued, this beta is going to be get bigger and bigger and bigger in the layer form, isn't it? But dear students, how, when this reaction is stopped, how this beta is going to form? No, dear students, isn't it? Because there should be the direct contact between the liquid and alpha was there initially. Now dear students, here I am saying that once the beta is grown, now the reaction is completely stopped because of no direct contact. But dear students, when there is no direct contact between this liquid and alpha dendrite, so this alpha is now going to diffuse. See here. See how this reaction get further continued. How this reaction get further continued even when the layer of beta is present in between this liquid and alpha. So definitely, dear students, it is because of diffusion. It is because of diffusion, dear students, the diffusion, that is the movement of the mass from the high concentration region to the low concentration region, and of course this is the function of temperature. For diffusion we need the temperature. So how this alpha now going to diffuse through this layer of beta? This alpha is now going to diffuse through this layer of beta and it is trying to get in contact with this liquid. So what is going to happen? So once again reaction gets started and layer is going to be more and more thicker, isn't it? So like that, because of the diffusion of this alpha through this layer of beta, again this reaction is get continued, dear students. But whether this diffusion is continued for the longer period of time? No, dear students, because diffusion is time dependent phenomena. That is, the distance, how much it is gets diffused, x, if I say distance, that is how much distance gets diffused, is equal to root of dt. You know this equation very well, dear students, where this x is equal to distance and this small t is equal to time. And where the, dear students, d is our what? The diffusivity. D is our what? Diffusivity, which is equal to d naught into e to the power minus q divided by t. This is the Arrhenius type of equation for the diffusion, dear students, where we know that it's small d naught is what? The diffusion constant. Q is the activation energy for this diffusion, that is in calorie per mole. R is the gas constant, that is 1.987 calorie per mole per Kelvin, and T is our absolute temperature. Okay, just for your information I am telling. So because of this diffusion, the reaction again gets started and again the beta layer is now growing. But dear students, kitni der ke liye sab chalega? So diffusion is not like that, it is happening and happening. Okay, सो ये टाइम डिपेंडेंट फेनोमेना है, तो कुछ देर बाद ये डिफ्यूजन भी क्या हो जाएगा? बंद हो जाएगा. सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, भले ये रिएक्शन कितनी भी देर तक चलेगी, लेकिन एट द एंड कुछ ना कुछ अल्फा क्या हो जाएगा? बिकॉज सी, टेम्परेचर तो डेफिनेटली इट इज हैविंग द ग्रेडियंट, सो इट इज डेफिनेटली रिड्यूसिंग रिड्यूसिंग रिड्यूसिंग, बिकॉज वी आर कूलिंग इट, इजंट इट? सो एंड डिफ्यूजन के लिए क्या चाहिए? टाइम चाहिए and temperature, isn't it? And of course time to lapse hota rahega jaise jaise cool hota rahega, isn't it? So that is the reason why, dear students, this alpha not completely get converted into this beta, because in between kya ho jayega? Ye jo material hai, liquid thanda hote hote cool ho jayega and it will become solid. So actually what will happen there, some alpha is going to left in this reaction, dear students. Okay, so as time increases, this alpha, some alpha is left over in the peritactic reaction, and the reaction therefore, dear students, never get completed. Okay, so it is not like that 100% alpha is going to convert into this beta. Why? Because some alpha is going to be there, because diffusion is a time dependent phenomena and we are cooling the material, that metal, continuously to the room temperature. So definitely kabhi na kabhi to ye reaction kya ho jayegi, stop ho jayegi, aur ye jo alpha hai, this alpha will get retained in this reaction. This alpha which is retained, dear students, is called as the properitactic alpha. This retained alpha, dear students, please remember, this retained alpha in this peritactic reaction is known as properitactic alpha, which is known as properitactic alpha, dear students. So this is how we can explain the reaction, dear students. Again, dear students, we can take another example, that is niobium, iron and boron, which is the strong magnet. Okay, so again in that also, see, in that also, dear students, we are having this gamma iron get formed, that is liquid plus this gamma iron is going to form, this niobium, iron and boron phase, which is the strong magnet, dear students. Here is the gamma iron, okay, and once it react with this liquid, definitely what is going to form? This phase is going to form, dear students. Okay, that is the phase of this niobium, ferrous and boron, which is a strong magnet. But what happened? Because this reaction never get completed, so some of this gamma iron is going to left in this reaction, okay, and which is not the strong magnet, dear students. This gamma is the where this gamma is going to retain, so at the interstitial side of this strong magnet, okay, this gamma iron, which is the weak magnet, is going to retain, and that results into what? One is strong magnet. If I am having one is strong magnet, and in that we are having one is weak magnet, so definitely resultant will be what? The weak magnet, isn't it? So that is a react. That is a reaction, actually, dear students. We are having in this the strong magnet. That is the reason, my dear students, the China has a very good command on this reaction. That is, the strong magnet is basically used in the headphones. And you can see, or you might be knowing, that the China is having more than 95 market shares in these headphones. That is, the reason is what? They have the mastery in this reaction. That is, they will not allow this gamma or this gamma iron to get retained at the interstitial sites of this strong magnet. Okay, so they are having their excellency in that. That is the reason why they are having more than 95% the share market share in these headphones. So dear students, this is about the peritectic reaction, and this is the explanation for the peritectic transformations. So thank you so much, dear students. Bye bye.